Alright, so we will start a new series, and in this series we are going to make an grabber. And before making the grabber, actually we will start to introduce the basics of AutoCAD 2D. So I will switch to this layout. Basically I am using the version 2009. It's old, but the basics of drawing and the basics of modeling is the same in all later versions. I have tried to install a newer version, but all the newer version crashes, and I don't know the reason of crashing. So basically, we will start from explaining the layout. Here we have some helper tools. We have the ortho, which you can, if you activate this one, you can draw a line straight like this, straight horizontally or straight vertically. So this will be helpful in this way. If you want to draw straight lines, you can use this ortho. And you can repeat the last command from right click and repeat line, or you can use enter to repeat this line. And you can draw a line, and this distance will be the distance to here. And basically we are using the grid. So here, let's try to define it later. So you can draw a circle, for example, and the center will be 0 and 0. So these are the coordinates, and the x and y, these are the coordinates in 2D axis. And after that, you can define the radius, for example, 5. So we have the drawing and circle. This is the center, and you can display the grid or not display it. And the basic line is the basic commands we will use. We will use the L for line, and this is the first point. You can start from a grid 5 and 5, and you can deactivate the ortho and going for any another point, maybe 2 and 2, which is here. So we are starting from 5 and 5, and this point will be relative to this one. So we have going 2 and 2, and it's not obligatory to start from using the points in axis. You can start from any line or any point from the center to be maybe this line to this point. Let's try to explain the ortho, which will be here. So if you right click, I mean the O snap, not the ortho. So you will see a lot of options here. We have the end point, the midpoint, the center, and a lot of options here. So let's try to explain this. I will delete all this. So to erase, you can select all and erase. Or if you want only select the circle, you can go like this. And this will select only the circle, because the going from right to left is selecting anything touches this rectangle. But this right blue rectangle select only this the whole object, which is, so if you select this, we will select two object, which is this line and this line and this circle, because all these are located inside our rectangle, which is a blue. So let's explain the O snap. Basically, if you have a line, I will delete all these. And I will start any lines, maybe here, and another line from here. And I'm trying to draw some temporary lines to explain what I mean. If you have activated the O snap, you have some options here. So all these options are, by default, all these options are activated. So we have the center, we have the intersection, we have the endpoint. If you want to activate any number of O snap other than, you can activate the tangent, and it will be activated. So if you try to draw a line, it will go to the this is the tangent. And if we want, you can draw line like this. If we want to activate a temporary O snapping, you can start from shift right click, and we want to miss the point from this one, and shift right click the midpoint from this line. So we have a lot of options in the O snapping. we will explain the most useful parts. So I will try to draw a line, and we want it to be a quadrant from here. So we have this point and this point, and start from here to the end point, which is here, end point, which is here. And we have also some another options. We have the midpoint, we have the intersection. So this is the intersection from this one to the end point. And we have also, we have the tangent, we have the perpendicular. So we can draw line from here and to be here. This is the perpendicular, or you can go here and try to deactivate the ortho to explain the perpendicular. So this is the perpendicular, which is here, and we are drawing line to be perpendicular, and we can draw also some node and insert and nearest. We have some setting here. So you can, all these are by default are activated. You can activate from here, and it says that you can activate if by F3 object snap on, and here is some shortcuts. Let's explain the node. If you have a rectangle which is here, and we can draw a line from the node, which is the intersection. I think it's the intersection from this. Right. Let's explain late the final snap we want go here. So I have line here and another line here. So if you want to draw a circle, and this circle started from the apparent intersection, which is here. So this intersection will be, you can start from here and specify the center, and this is the intersection. So again, we want to draw a circle, and it's intersection from this line to this line. So it's intersection apparent, because it's actually not intersection, but if we extend this line, it's already intersection. So we want to select, let's try to select this circle, and we will select this point from here, because already this one intersection from this one. Because this line, if we extend, it will extend intersection here, and you, if you want to select the apparent intersection, you should actually choose two objects. Alright, now we will go straight to see how we can draw a basic shape. So we can draw a line, as I have said. This is the first point, and this is the second point. You can draw a circle, and there is a lot of options in the circle. You can draw from the center radius. We specify the center, and we specify the radius, which is maybe 12. And again, you can try to the diameter, and you can try to draw a circle from 2 points. And it's now you should make notice always to the command line, and say that what is the first point of this circle diameter. So we can say that this is the first circle, and we want to draw from here, and the second point may be going to be here, and it will actually draw a circle from here to here. We have a lot of options. We can start from 3 point, and this is a point, and this is another. We want to be tangent to this one, and we want the third point. It's say this is the third point. So so it, we have drawn a circle from the 3 points. We can start from tangent and the tangent and the radius. So this is another tangent, and this is another tangent. And we say that the radius will be 10, and it has drawn circle. If we make an increased circle, it may be starting to be going here. let's try to define the hexagonal. We it say what is number of sides. We say that we have seven number, and he is asking now about the center. So I will say the center will be 1 and 1, and enter an option. Say, do you want to calculate this? And if you want to go straight, you can activate the ortho, and we are now drawing this circle, and the radius will be 25. And after that, we have some, I think this is ellipsoid. We have hatching. You can hatch any of these. If you want to print, you can hatch. You can go to hatch. And after that, you select an big points or select an joint. And we are selecting now the internal point, which is here, and click enter. And you can switch from this pattern. You can select any pattern like this. And the preview after that, let's see what is the preview. As you can see, the scale is very, very small. So we will click the escape and set the scale to large number and test. So you can go to 5 and the preview, maybe 7 to be much better, and I will click OK. This is what the hatching work. And we have the rectangle, which is here, and the starting point, let's from 0 and 0, and the next point will be, let's say, 50 and 50. And as you can see, we have make a circle from here to a rectangle extended from here to here. And there is some options you must know. We have the zoom. If you click Z in the command line, it say what you want to zoom. I want to zoom to extended, so I will click E to zoom to this object. Basically, you have some modify options that you should know. Firstly, if you want to move some object, you can select the move or M from this command line. And after that, it's saying select object to move. I will select this rectangle and click enter. And it's now asking about the base point. I will select this point, which is here. And it's now selecting the second point to move. I will move to be this point. And it's now moving our object. Let's talk about the copy. If I want to copy, you can go here and copy or CO from this command line, and I will select this object, which is a rectangle, and after that I will click enter and selecting this baseline, and I want copy to be ortho. If you want to not copy in the ortho, you can select this and copy as you want from here to be here. So we have copied it 4 times as you expect, like this. And we have also the some options which is the stretch. I want to explain it. If we have some line here, and if we have some line from here to here, and I want to extend this line, so I will click the extend and select the base point, which is here, and select second point from here. So I will select this object and click enter, select the base point and click enter. Stretch, select object and enter, base point and second point, which is here. And we have some offset options, so you can select this rectangle and click O to offset, and offset distance will be 5, and point on side of the offset, we will select the inner, and you can select again and outer, and as you can see, we are making some offset like this. We have also the trim options, so I will click and draw a line from here to here and another line from here to here. Then I will click the trim TR and select all object to cutter to be cutter, and I will select all these lines, so we have trim some options here, and we can delete this one. And again, we can trim and select some points here to draw this shape, which is you can expect like this. So now we will talk about the fillet and chamfer. We have already here some basic shape. We have this rectangle, and I will click the fillet from here. And as you can see, it say first object, I will select this object, and second object, I will select this object also. Let's try again the fillet, and I select this first object and second object here, and it say can't fill it. So I will try to define it or explain it in another line. So we have two lines here, and we want to apply the chamfer or the fillet. The fillet make some arc, and the chamfer making this line. So I will try to start from the fillet and select the first object, which is here. I select the second object, which is here, and it say let's go back, and first object, which is here, second object, which is here. And because we have it make the radius of zero, it hasn't make any fillet. So we will start and from our radius to be around four, and first object, which is here, second object, which is here, and it has already make an arch. So let's define how the chamfer work. We can the chamfer work as 90 degrees or making an edge. So we can start from an chamfer, and its first line, which is here, second line, which is here, and because we have chamfer of 0 and 0, you can go back and select the distance from here. So we have the distance. The first distance will be 5, second distance will be 7, and first line, which is here, and second line, which is here. And as you can see, we have make an chamfer, and you can make already an rectangle chamfer. Let's talk about the extend. We have here an extend and trim. We already have explained the trim, and let's now explain the extend. So I will select this object and click OK, and select the crossing or fence. So I will select all these lines, and so we extending from here. Let's extend it to be here. So I select all like this. And let's select this one, and it already extended to be here. So finally, we'll talk about the array. So we can say that we have a circle from here to here, and we want to apply an array from this. You can apply an polar array or an array which is rectangular. So we can preview like this, and it's already stacked with all other, because we haven't defined the offset. So the row offset will be around 100, and this one will be 80, 100, and we can review like this. And as you can see, we have this nice shape. So let's again increase the distance. We can increase the row or decrease the column, and the row column of this will be 150, and this one will be 200 to make larger distance. And you can see some review here, and let's preview. And as you can see, you can click enter to accept this array, and already you can zoom to extend this to see all these circles. And basically, you can make an polar array. How we can make an polar array? Firstly, I want to make some intersection from this tangent, which is here, to this tangent, and other line tangent from here and to this tangent. And I will select another let's say rectangle. This rectangle will be here. Then I will select all these rectangles and make another array. This time will be a polar array, and it's asking us what is the center. So we have total number of around 5, and angle of this, and we want to pick the center. So this is the center. And let's preview. We have already 5 starting from here to here, and you can accept now. So in the polar array, you select the object, you select the center, and you select how numbers of copy you want to this object. We already talked about the erase. You can select any object and erase from here like this. And we already talked about the explode, I think not. So let's talk about the final commands you can select. This is an object, and you can explode like this, and now it's exploded to these elements. So we can also select this object and mirror MI from here to and this to also like this. So select enter and we have mirrored, and this mirror command you will use all the time in your drawing. And I think we can now talk about how to save your file, and I think we didn't talk about the join. So these are four lines, and you, if you go here and join like this, you will see so I don't actually know why it isn't joined. Alright, so let's talk about the layers and how you can save your file. We have here change space, and I think we will talk about the rotate. So we have here an object, and we can rotate base point, which is here, and you can rotate to angle any angle you want to start. So this angle may be 130 and like this, and already we have layers. So you can go here to layers and add any layers like this. You you can start to add lines, and this is the color. Choose the color you would like, and you have to start another layer, which is maybe rectangles or anything, and this layer is the color, and you can choose the line type line. If you want to load any number of lines, it will be here, and you can choose the thickness also like this, and you can after making or drawing in some area in some layer, you can hide like this, or you can isolate. Finally, you can save your file. Click here and save your file, and now I think we have explained the most basics of the 2D CAD drawing. So in the next chapter, we will see how we can draw a simple 3D model inside AutoCAD.